Please stand as we begin our celebration.
Good evening. And we remember that Easter, we're celebrating the third Sunday Easter. Easter is about joy because we believe that the Lord is risen. And that is why we rejoice saying Alleluia. Alleluia, because the Lord is risen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And with the joy of this third Sunday of Easter, we begin our celebration by saying together, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we prepare ourselves to be part of this joyful celebration of Easter, I invite you to take a moment to recognize, to bring to your mind your personal sins, and believing in the mercy of the Lord, to take the moment to ask for forgiveness. And believing that God is merciful with those who repent, let us all say together, I confess to Almighty God, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have really sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do, through my fault, most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to Almighty God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ,
and we rejoice with the risen Lord, singing the glory of our God.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. For you, great glory, Lord God, heavenly King. O God, almighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand,
the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth.
And let us pray. May your people exalt forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles.
Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of your fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence. When he decided to release him, you denied the holy and righteous one and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him up from the dead, and of us we are witnesses. Now, my brothers, you acted out of ignorance just as your leaders did, but God has thus brought to fulfillment. He has announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. My children,
I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, and not only for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, I know him, but do not keep his commandments are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones. As you can see, I have." And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "This is written, that the Christ will suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and the repentance for the forgiveness of sins will be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. And you are witnesses of these things." The gospel, the good news of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Please be seated for a moment. Easter is the most precious time when we are invited as a community to rejoice each other. Because during the Easter, we praise God for the salvation that he has given us through his only Son, Jesus Christ, who has been raised from the dead. And Easter was a special moment in the life of Jesus' disciples. Today, during the last Sundays, two Sundays, has been the Gospel of John recounted to us how Jesus revealed to his disciples. And today is Luke to his Gospel that from his own eyes, he recounted to all of us how this joyful moment of the risen Lord took place. And we need to understand where were the disciples in this moment when Jesus revealed himself. They just went through a very depressing time. You know, when they were with Jesus, seeing what he was doing, what he was preaching, how the people came around him, and they were amazed by everything that was done for Jesus. But after he was handed over to the leaders of the church, and they asked to be crucified because they were jealous of him. And how they walk away from Jesus. You can imagine how they were feeling after his crucifixion. So that is so important for Jesus to reveal himself to them. And the way in today's gospel from Luke, today, how Jesus approached them when they were talking about maybe being truthful that he is risen, especially when these two disciples that they were coming back from Emmaus, they were saying how they were able to recognize him by the breaking of bread. And isn't that conversation when Jesus, in a very gentle way, revealed to them, saying, "Peace be with you." That is what the disciples need to hear from Jesus. Peace be with you. Is a peace of healing. Jesus is embracing his disciples again. Even though they abandon him, even though they betray him, even though they deny him, today Jesus is coming to them with the peace of healing. And that healing come to them when Jesus said, "Touch me. Is myself." And even when the disciples were afraid, and after touching him and receive that energy, somebody who is alive in his glory, they were amazed. But they were healed. And that's the moment when Jesus said to them, "Everything that has been written in the law of Moses, through the prophets, to the Psalms, about the Christ that has to be crucified but raised on the third day, everything of that has been to be fulfilled by the glory of God." And he said to them, "And you are witnesses of this." It is important to see how the disciples recovered everything that Jesus has done, because he opened their minds so they could understand the scriptures. And with this powerful encounter with the risen Lord, we, all of us here, we could be amazed in the first reading of the Act of the Apostles. We can understand the power of the healing of the peace of the Lord to his disciples. When Peter, in today's first reading, he said to them, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, and the God of our fathers has glorified his servant, Jesus, who you handed over to the cross." And then Peter said, "Everything that took place in Jerusalem of the risen Lord, of Jesus being risen by the Lord," now he said with all confidence, with the same confidence that Jesus said to them in the gospel, now Peter and the other disciples, they are saying to all the people, and we, the disciples of Jesus, We are witnesses of everything that had happened. That truly, truly, Jesus is alive, and that he is a way for the forgiveness of our sins. That is what Easter means in the life of the disciples, that they have recovered themselves for the traumatic moment they went through seeing Jesus on the cross. And that is what Easter should mean with us. That we ourselves, knowing the challenges that we may face in our journey of faith, that Easter will be an opportunity to allow Jesus to come to each one of us, saying, peace be with you. And that peace that Jesus is giving you is a peace of the power of his healing. That you will allow the risen Lord to restore any situation, any event that has destroyed your wholeness as a disciple of Jesus. That Jesus will say to you, and you are my witness, and you will say to those you touch with your life, with your words, with your faith, that you will say to those people, yes, I can say this because I have witnessed the presence of God in my life. Lord, let your face shine on us. Amen.
Amen.
And truly believing that Jesus is alive, let us renew our faith by saying together, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father.
Spirit.
The God who raised Jesus from the dead will give us all we need to come to a new life. Let us pray that our minds and heart be opened to recognize him in all we encounter.
For the church, that we may be persistent in manifesting the Lord's peaceful presence in the entire world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That leaders of every nation will discover new ways to bring peace and peace with justice into our world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who are away from home this Easter season, particularly members of the military and relief workers, that God will protect and guide them and bring them home safely, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For an end to violence, that Christ's victory over death will turn hearts from violence and revenge and help us to respect the value and dignity of each human life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who gather around the Eucharistic table, that we may come to know Jesus in the breaking of the bread, so we may become more dynamic disciples, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who are sick, Elvira Agron, Conrad Anchita, Teresa French, the homebound and for their caregivers, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who has died, Maximum Anchita, Eugene Baca, Jerry Barris, Jeffrey Christopher, Edgar Coe, Kathleen Hardy, Mateo Yanez, may they join with Christ in the new life that he shares with his Father. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have asked for our prayers and for the intentions we carry in the quiet of our hearts, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers. O God, hear the prayers of your people. Open our hearts to continual conversion that have witnesses to the power of Jesus' resurrection, we may preach love and forgiveness in his name. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have a wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, and it will become our spiritual drink. And pray, brothers and sisters, that this sacrifice of the Eucharist, mine, but also yours, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands,
for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and all the good of His church. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her house for such great gladness, grant also that the gift we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all the time to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time of Easter above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death. By rising, restore our life. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, we sing together the unending hymn of your glory as we acclaim. Found all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift, we pray, by sending down upon them your Holy Spirit,
like the fall, so that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks again, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. And do this in memory of me. The mystery of our faith.
Proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be here in your presence and minister to you. We pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, all the clergy, deacons, and lay ministers. And remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles and martyrs, Saint Peter, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. As a community in the presence of the risen Lord, we approach our Father in heaven by praying together the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. And grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
And Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostle, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not in our sins, but in the faith of your church, and grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
And may the peace of the risen Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
And let us give one another a sign of peace. Peace. Peace.
Shalom.
Peace be with you, Adrian.
Peace, Jen.
William, peace. Peace be with you. Are you by yourself?
And this is Jesus, the one who brings peace to those who believe in him, is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. And happy are you because you are invited to the supper of the Lord. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. But only say a word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
shepherd's might. I am the truth and light. I am the way and life. I am who am, and I am for you. Come and follow me. I ran for the bird.
And let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those who are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And please be seated.
Please take home today's bulletin for other parish news and upcoming events.
And the Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. It's so nice to be a happy community that we can laugh together. And please bow your head for a special blessing this Easter time. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing, and the people respond.
Amen.
May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs of eternal inheritance, and the people respond.
Amen.
May you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven, and the people respond.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
And go and become a witness of the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia,
alleluia.
And have a good night.
You too, Father. And
people of God, see the morning is new. Rise from your sleeping and run to the tomb. Come and see. Come and see, he is alive. A grave that is empty, a
Thank you all.
I hope I didn't screw it.